Hello everyone, my name is Adèle Joyeux. I'm an earth science student and you are watching Polar Tree Channel. A polar tree is something that shouldn't exist, but in some parts of Siberia they are growing. They are the physical manifestation of the changes we are facing now. This channel aims to take you to a journey to discover the fascinating and fragile beauty of the frozen world, the cryosphere, where the water is ice. Today, we are going to the truly amazing Pleistocene Park in Yakutia in Siberia. I want you to know that I am passionate about permafrost. I will explain what it is further in the video, don't worry. And on this channel, we will travel a lot and you will see earth science related cryosphere topic, but not only earth science, also other points of view. I will make some interview and a lot of fun stuff. So stay tuned, come with me, join me for the journey. And I want you to know that for the next video we are going to Svalbard, so stay tuned. And as you can see, I've called this video episode 1 because I hope in the future there will be an episode 2 with an actual interview of Sergei and Nikita Simov, who are the father and son team of Pleistocene Park. Sergei, Nikita, if you are watching me. Okay, so let's go to Yakutia. Oh, and just a little teaser, for the next video we are going to Svalbard with my dear friend Amandine. I already did the interview with her and it will be amazing. I can't wait to show you this. Okay, so stay tuned, subscribe, do all the things. Let's go to Yakutia now. And as I said earlier, I will talk about permafrost to explain you why this project is so important. After that, I will take you to a little tour in the park. And after the little tour, the science part. Very easy science. And I want you to know that the idea of this channel popped up while I was thinking about a way to help them with the Pleistocene Park project, because I think it's essential to humanity, and I wanted to help them, and the idea came while I was thinking about a way to do that. So this video in particular is very important for me. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you learn a lot. I also want you to know that all the photos you see come from the website from Pleistocene Park. I linked it below. So go and check. I highly recommend you to check it. The first thing you need to know is that Pleistocene is the scientific word for Ice Age. It's the same. Pleistocene Park aims to recreate the ecosystem from Ice Age, pursuing to prevent the permafrost thawing. It's located in Siberia, in Yakutia, in Russia, just here. The scientist behind this is Sergei Simov, and the director of the park is Nikita Simov, his son. The climate change is really true to them because they see it everywhere around them, in the landscape, in the permafrost that is thawing, and their fight may save us all. So first, I will explain why the thawing of the permafrost is a huge problem for humanity, and then I will take you to the park, and after that, a little word about science, but just a little word, don't worry. So, what is permafrost? I draw a little shame. Permafrost is where the soil is frozen, minimum 2 meters deep, and at least 2 years consecutively. And there can be a layer at the top that is unfrozen seasonally. It's called the active layer. The permafrost can be continuous or discontinuous, and it's mainly formed from frozen wetland. It's hard to say. formed from frozen wetland. Okay, but the permafrost is thawing. And it's a problem because of the greenhouse gases that are locked in the ice. With the thawing, the ice melts and the gases are released in the atmosphere. And these greenhouse gases are methane and CO2. Methane is a really, really powerful greenhouse gas. It's very much powerful than CO2. And there are also bacteria that were sleeping, but with the increase of temperature, they awake and they produce even more greenhouse gases. And the line of the permafrost moved to the north. You may have heard of the pessimistic climate model that says that the temperature will increase in the next years. Well, you have to know that these models don't count the greenhouse gases from the permafrost. And the scientists estimate them 1 billion tons. It's a lot. It's huge. And it's a time bomb. Don't worry, I will make a whole video about permafrost in the next year. But for now, let's just go to the park. Animals have to be in an efficient population density. This way, the herbivores, while they are searching for food, they remove the snow cover, and therefore they allow thermal exchange between the soil and the air, and this way the soil is cooled and it's preventing the thaw. It's amazing. But as I previously told you, the polar trees are growing, and you have to know that trees need a specific temperature conditions. To make samples, no trees is very cold, like in tundra. Conifer is cold, like in taiga, but caduceus, the trees who lost their leaves in the winter, these trees are not cold at all, they are temperate. And they warm the soil with their roots. There are some eras where the trees are vital, such as Amazonia, where we shouldn't cut any trees at all over there, but in this particular case it's a problem. It's heartbreaking to cut them, but it's vital, and they accelerate the process of the thaw, so we have to cut them. During the ice age, mammoths were playing the role of cutting the tree in this particular era. And as you know, it's an extinct species, and the team is dreaming about having an actual mammoth or maybe a genetically modified elephant to play this role in the ecosystem. Okay, now let's dig into the science part. Don't worry, I make it simple for you. If you are curious, if you want to learn more, I linked their website down below, and you can find all sorts of things, and I synthesized them for you here, but there are a lot more. I recommend you to go and check. So the mammoth steppe ecosystem from the ice age was stable during hundreds of thousands of years. The presence of both herbivores like elephants and cows and predators like wolves and tigers were the keystone of the ecosystem. This ecosystem was able to regulate the climate by stabilizing the carbon balance, locking it in the biomass in the warm period and release it in the atmosphere during the cold period. Biomass is the scientific word for living beings. But something happened. A new predator arrived and broke the balance. Guess which one? And things got worse with the beginning of the agriculture and pastoral, and even more with the industrial era. Now, with this project, we have a chance to recreate this ecosystem, and it will take place in an unpopulated era. And we can begin with this to restore the carbon balance. And don't you think it's worth to help them? Now, I want to share a tip with you that one of my teachers, Philippe Sorel, told me. Don't tell him, but he's one of my favorites. He's an amazing paleolimnologist. It means that he studies lakes and rivers from the past. And what he told me that is that I should try mindfulness meditation to manage my stress during the exams. And I tried, I did it, and it was life-changing. I gained 3 pounds in the French system. I went to the top 10, to the top 3 of my class. So I was very comfortable with the exam. Okay, that's it for the tip I wanted to share with you. It's over for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I did. Join me for the next one. Remember, I told you we are going to Svalbard. We are going there with one of my dear friends. So stay tuned, subscribe, like, and all those things. And see you in the next video. Bye bye.